Okay, hi. I'm Banjo. This is my first stream I've ever done. I've never used, well, I've used Twitch a bit, but not a whole lot, so this is sort of an experiment. I'll probably need a lot of advice on how I'm doing things and how I'm setting things up. So if the audio doesn't look great, or if the video's too far behind, let me know. It's gonna be a little bit, like I said, it's gonna be a little bit of an experiment. So I guess I'm gonna play Dark Souls Remastered. I've heard a lot about this game. It's a really hard game, so I know people like to watch the streams, just because they want to see people get angry, I guess. I'm probably not too much like that, but I have played Bloodborne, and that was a really tough game. I probably got about 90% of the way done with that one, and just other things came up, and I couldn't finish. But it was, I've already played a little bit of this one, and so it's been, it's actually a little, the beginning at least was easier than I remember Bloodborne being at the beginning. This one seems to ease you in a little bit, as compared to that one. But I'm gonna start a new game here. Even though I played a little bit already, I'm just gonna start from the beginning. I mean, there's some pretty odd things about this. Now, like I said, I've never played this before, and I was used to Bloodborne. I'm sure from and kind of they probably figured a few things out before they by the time they got to Bloodborne. This one, the UI is seems very odd.
Then there was fire, and with fire came disparity, heat and cold, life and death, and of course, light and dark. Then from the dark, they came and found the souls of lords within the flame. Nito, the first of the dead. the Witch of Izalith, and her Daughters of Chaos. Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight, and his faithful knights.
Raise the sun. That's what they say in this game, right?
And the furtive pygmy, so easily forgotten. With the strength of lords, they challenge the dragons. Gwyn's mighty bolts peeled apart their stone skins. The witches weaved great firestorms. Nito unleashed a miasma of death and disease. And Seath, the scales, betrayed his own. And the dragons were
killed.
Thus began the Age of Fire. But soon the flames will fade.
Looks like pretty nice there.
And only dark
after they
figure
a few things out.
Even now, there are only embers. And man sees not light, but only endless nights. And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side. Yes,
this is a
PS.
This is a
the
PS3
dark
game.
Sign brands the undead.
I think it looks pretty good. They did a pretty good job.
And in this land, the undead are corralled and led to the north. Where they are locked away to await the end. The world. This is your fate.
What were those rats crawling along the edge towards him? Yeah, so you start this game, and I did all that character creator stuff, and then they throw me in here, and I'm just like a dead dude. I don't know if there's any resemblance to what I chose. Doesn't really look like it. Maybe just the body type. Got a broken sword. Like I said, they ease you into it pretty well. They let you kill this guy, practice hitting stuff. get a little XP there. There's this thing walking around in here. Yeah. So this is like the clumsiest roll I've ever seen in a video game before. It's like a... I don't know. It's like if I were actually to put on armor right now, this is how I would roll. I would, like, fall on my face. That's what it feels like. Which is a pretty jarring contrast to Bloodborne, where basically you just roll all the time. All over the place. And now the roll is like, I just... hit the ground like a ton of bricks. Boom. Anyway, it's pretty silly. I don't think you're supposed to use the rolling a lot in this game. Not nearly as much as you do in Bloodborne. They want me to lock here, so you lock with R3. The UI in this game is really weird. I wonder if they improved it at all, because it's just... I mean, it's okay, but... You can definitely tell it's not a modern game. It's taken me a little bit to figure out what's going on with it, and like, they... For instance, they just leave this window up here. And then they let you walk around, but then they don't let you attack. And so numerous times when I was playing before, I just leave that window up there and I go to attack something, and I didn't realize I had to cancel out that window. Okay, so let's get into it. This is basically just a big long tutorial section. They'll show me everything. So the bonfires are like the safe spots. You gotta get to a bonfire without dying, which becomes increasingly difficult. So, yeah, I think I just go right into these doors now. There's more options here. That's one. When I first did this, I thought, okay, they give me an entire window, and I have one option to leave. That's like, like I said, the UI is really strange. They'll just refill. I think, I don't know, I've had more than five before, but it seems like they just got enough shoot arrows at me. arrows go really slow. Slower than actual arrows, so you can actually dodge them a little bit. So now I've got a shield, so here we go. Change equipment. I've got a shield. So I can do that now. Still got this crummy sword. Which maybe I can kill some of these guys. What's going on here? Oh, see, I left the menu up there again. Oh, he ran away. Slow those arrows go. Oh yeah, and then the other thing is these bodies just ragdoll all over the place. It's really funny. It's, you can tell it's an old game. Was this PS3? I think it's PS3, right? Maybe it was PS2. I don't know. And I don't know. I think those are just basically loading screens. You guys over here that I need it. Not this way. Like I said, I've played this part before, so this tutorial part, so should be able to skip through it pretty quick. That was coming. I did not dodge it the first time I played this part. As you can imagine. It opens up this hole here.
Oh, you. You're no Hollow. Thank goodness. I'm done for, I'm afraid. I'll die soon. Then lose my sanity. I wish to ask something of you. You and I, we're both undead. Hear me out, will you?
So is this the guy that gave me the key? I think it might be.
Regrettably, I have failed in my mission. But perhaps you can keep the torch lit. There is an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead art chosen. And thine exodus from the undead asylum maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient lords. When thou ringeth the bell of awakening, the fate of the undead thou shalt know. Well, now you know. And I can die with hope in my heart. Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. An Estus flask. An undead favorite.
He spelled favorite the UK way.
Oh, and this. Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death.
I'm gonna part with that shield. That shield looks long.
And thank you.
The shield looks nicer than mine.
Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go on.
He talks about being undead, but then harming me after death.
I would hate to hug.
It seems like, yeah, like the undead are just normal dudes, but then I've got all these baddies walking around here that also seem undead.
No, I must bid farewell.
So I'm a little confused about that. I don't really understand what's the difference between like an undead with actual capacity to make decisions, or just these drones walking around. Oh, that's right. I was gonna open up this down here. So this is like this part was like, oh yeah, Bloodborne. If you haven't played these games before, they kind of they have really creative level designs so that you'll end up opening up a door that's a shortcut. And I think I said this. Well, no, I don't think I did. The bonfires, they heal you, but they also, all the enemies come back, which is the same with Bloodborne. All the enemies come back after you, I think it's after you, like, light those lanterns. I think that's what happens. But, or every time you die, they all come back, in Bloodborne at least. I think it might just be every time you die, but in this, if you end up lighting those fires, you get, all the enemies come back. So then you need, like, so how do you make progress? Well, you unlock doors and things so you can kind of go back to where, like, take shortcuts and things, which is really useful. So I really like that about these games. I think it's a specific From Software thing that they do that is pretty neat. They want me to wield two-handed, which I don't know about that. I'll do it, but so you can kind of do this, like, back dash, and it's pretty quick. If you try to roll, though, you do the throw yourself on the ground thing. I'm sure that two-handed wielding is... that went crazy. I don't know, I think I like using the shield. I feel safer. Especially against guys with more arrows. So, they have all these blood stains on the ground, too. They're images, like after images of other players that have walked through here. I don't know if they have to die. That was in Bloodborne, too. I wondered if they added this to the remastered version, or if that was always in these games. Because I don't think there would have been an online component in the original, so I think that's something they must have added. So here's a guy. Here's the first guy I run into that actually has a shield. Oh, should probably lock onto him, right? Kind of do this like forward jump strike. I think it's a little stronger and kind of like, yeah, like that. Or you can do a, you can, that's like the heavy attack, forward heavy attack. A forward light attack is like a kick, like kind of like a Spartan kick. But he kind of points his toe a little bit, doesn't look that great. If I'm, you know, since I'm a kicking expert, but it's locked. I don't remember how I would get back here. I gotta keep looking over the chat, making sure no one's here. Well, there might be people watching, but no one's chatting. Like I said, if you guys, are, whoever has joined it, I've never streamed before. This is my first stream ever. Never had any, I haven't really spent a lot of time on Twitch. I think I'd like to spend more time on it and kind of start watching a few more streams and doing this thing more. Do I have to go that way? I think I do. There he is, looking up at me. So if I jump and I jump down on him. I might die here. I was supposed to jump on top of him, but I that did not work out. Okay. Woo! I can get behind him, I think. Stabbing in the back. Yep. Got it. So there was that locked door. I don't think I ever unlocked that door before. I might go try that again. So if I rest here, I redo all the enemies. So I'm not going to do that right now. I think that's a bad idea. So I'll fight everyone again. I don't want to do that. I should probably put the chat up on the screen, shouldn't I? I don't know, I feel like you guys can see more of the screen if I do this. I can just look down at my iPad for any chat. The thing is, I'm not looking down very often, and so anyone wants to say anything, it's like... So yeah, there's a door over here. Let me go check that out. If I can't get in this one, then I don't know where the key is. It's locked. Okay. Huh. I don't know. That's weird. I feel like I've cleared this whole area, so I'm not sure. Maybe I missed something, but... Oh well. I'll move on. No clues in that room, that's for sure. This guy end up dying? Gone. He's gone. He must have wandered off because... Yeah, so the Estus flask, it gets replenished when I rest. Maybe I will rest then, get my flasks back, but... Actually, no, there's a cutscene, and then I get another bonfire almost immediately, so I'm not gonna worry about it. Spoiler alert. You can hear this thumping. And the whole time I was here, I was like, what the heck is that thumping? It's like this... over and over again. I think it's... You sort of find out.
It is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen. To leave the undead asylum in pilgrimage to the land of the ancient lords.
Taken by a giant crow.
Lordran.
So bad until you show up. And then it's overrun. So now they're gonna let me level up. Know what to do, the way to spec. Like I said with the character creator, I'm kind of, I don't like spending a ton of time on this stuff, but I spec kind of like warrior stuff. I like kind of playing the warrior. So I think like things like strength, vitality, endurance, good. There's a lot of stats here. I think in Bloodborne, if it's like Bloodborne, the stats are important. But in the end, it's all up to you. It's learning the way the guys move and the bosses move and learning a way to beat them. It's not really as much. It's not like an RPG where I can just like keep fighting guys over and over again and just become totally overpowered. It doesn't work like that. I don't know, they have this covenant, this Kindle. No humanity. I don't know. I can use that humanity that I got. And you see I have like a humanity stat. And oh, and you can see other players near the bonfire. You can actually see actual other players near the bonfire. So like I said, I think that's new. Offer humanity and reverse Halloween. I don't really know what that means. Does that mean I just look like I'm human then? I'm not sure. I'll have to look at that.
Well, what do we have here? You must be a new arrival. Let me guess. Fate of the undead, right? Well, not the first. But there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the undead asylum. Too late now. Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are, actually, two bells of awakening. One's up above in the undead church. The other is far, far below, in the ruins at the base of Blight Town. Ring them both, and something happens. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on. But I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land, the undead.
Watch you guys listen to the voice acting.
Ah, your face. You're practically hollow. I don't know. Going hollow could solve quite a bit.
Yeah, I don't know what it means to be. I'm dead. If I offer humanity, do I become... do I become stronger? If I become human again or something? I don't really... yeah, I just got free humanity, so... okay. I don't know, maybe I'll try it. Oops. I gotta use the arrow first. Use... all three of them. So, offer humanity and reverse hollowing. Yes. Okay. Humanity restored. So yeah, I'm human now. I don't know what that does. Am I faster? I just feel like I'm all... no, maybe not. Not sure what that does. I mean, does it do anything for my stats to be alive again? Will I turn back to undead if I go back to the bonfire? I'm not really sure what that does. I'm gonna look that up. So before I put a little detour over here. So I did get all the way to the first boss. And then after that, I got up to him once, I died, and then I stopped playing. So I went this way before, but there's this graveyard down here, and there's all these skeletons, and they're pretty strong. So I kind of decided to hold off on that, hoping maybe I'll get some better weapons. There's that crow from before, unless there's more than one giant crow. Try to throw something at him or something like that. I think there is some stuff up here, so I'll collect that. And then I'm gonna go up, not down. I get these souls. They basically just give me a bunch of souls. And souls are the currency, so... but you don't really want to spend... or you don't want to really... you don't really want to use those items, because... if you die, all of your souls get left at your body. But all your items remain in your inventory, so, like, it doesn't really make a lot of sense to leave those behind. Or, it makes sense to leave those in your inventory, because you're going to take them with you, so. I don't know if you can die multiple times, and get back to, like, your multiple bodies and get back the souls that you died with at each of those times, or if, like, you can, or if it only, like, keeps, like, a cache of one.
Hello there. I believe we are not acquainted. I am Petrus of Tharalamut. Have you business with us? If not, I'd prefer to keep a distance, if possible.
If I keep bothering you, it gives you something.
Hello there. I realize that I have requested that we retain our distance, but I also want you to know that it is not meant in ill will. Here, take this as a token of peace. No, go ahead. It's for you.
I don't know what that does.
Oh my... Oh, I have to awake. So what if I were to teach you? Would that please you?
I guess so.
Very well.
I already know that.
Let me share my miracle. Only their ultimate effectiveness will be determined by your efforts.
I don't know what this guy is trying to... He sells me miracles, which I guess they're just like magic.
Come
which I
again.
Guess I already...
The effectiveness of the teachings depend upon your faith.
Yeah, I already have a miracle. I thought. There's not an item I can equip, so I'm not sure. I'm gonna have to Google some of this stuff to figure it out. These games are pretty dense sometimes. They don't really reveal too much to you. Kind of let you figure it out on your own. And the story is usually just as baffling. That's the impression I get. Bloodborne story was... It didn't make any sense to me. I know there's, like, a series of YouTube videos explaining what exactly just happened, but... cracked red eye orb. So I got another weapon. I'm not gonna use that, though. Homeward Bone. So if I go this way, I do have to fight the skeletons. I forgot about that. But I only have to fight one set, so that should be okay, since I've done it before. They're pretty tough. Probably it's talisman. Stay over here. Nope. Okay. So, if I heavy hit these guys, they collapse. Get the fall down in this game. Ah. Okay, I got one. Okay. Sheesh. Okay, so we're gonna go up to this upper area. That's where I went before. And maybe if I spend some extra time looking like I know what I'm doing. See, these guys are a lot easier. Really just like one or two hits and they're done. I gotta like kick them along. I couldn't swing my sword in here before, and that rat like poisoned me. And I died multiple times dealing with that. I haven't found a lot of shortcuts on this side, which is what I was bummed out about. Should be a shortcut. Like, on the other side of this wall or something. I don't know. way is the right way to go? Oh, first I better get this guy. Of the crates. So I've been going around whacking these things. There's nothing in there. Oh, here's this guy. He's coming around up here. You can jump down, buddy? Alright. Come on. So I think I just jumped down. He's awake right here. Off. See all of them hanging over off over there? I wonder if I like threw something at them if they'd fall down. Probably. It just feels like there's some other secret passageways or something that I'm missing, or maybe I'll stumble upon them later. Come on, guys. Let's get up. Time to go. Rubbish. This guy says amazing treasure. Got a lot of likes with that comment. All right, where the? I wish I could find out how to get like up there. Like I said, there's so many little things, little passageways and stuff that I feel like I'm missing. See where I'm trying to go though, right? There's like a little place up there. Anyway, I think I gotta walk through that little white. think. Was there stairs in here? No. There's a platform up there. I guess it's this way. Maybe some of this stuff opens up later. I'm not sure. Across there. How am I supposed to do that? I don't know. I'm not sure what they're wanting me to do there. Jump instead of just falling on my face. So that's just comes out of nowhere, of course. So he gives me a short sword, which I never got this before, so let me check it out. It's not that much damage, less damage. It's probably a lot faster. There's actually a bonfire in there, so we'll do that in a second. Gotta kill these chumps. Better.
down here?
No.
Yeah, I don't care.
You seem to have your wits about you. Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
Orange guidance. Oh, yeah. So the only thing I got here before was these throwing knives. I thought those looked like they might be good. Are useful.
Thank you kindly. Oh, I hope you... Things are getting treacherous in these parts. A horrible goat demon has moved in below. And up above, there's that humongous drake and a bull demon too. If you stick around this place, it might end up being your grave. What a waste of time.
What's that fight, dude? There's so many little spots. Like right there. Can I drop down on that? I mean, all those little places. I don't want to fall and die, but... So that's where I came up from there. Once I jump down, I can't really go back. Oh, this is that. Oh, so I wonder if I can roll and get into that place over there. I bet I can. Okay, let's try it. Yeesh. Nope. Who's this guy? Do it, but I guess not. Oh well. Give it a try. Alright, I guess I'll go do that bonfire now. Revive all these guys. Actually, there's an item in here first. Mm-hmm. And there's a bonfire here. Light. Do get more stamina with endurance, which I guess is good. Do that. Give myself some stamina. I don't know if there's ever gonna be a chance to drop that ladder down or something, because like I said, there's shortcuts. There's a way to get up there, but see, all the guys are back now. Running right at me. Again. Doors. Yeah, thanks. Oh. I'm kind of being impatient. I think the furniture all resets too if they could be a door behind one of these things.
You never know. Go that way, and I did before, but it didn't really help me do anything. I remember. Of course, I can't get into this door. Back to where I stopped earlier. It's like that room. Where that door was locked. It didn't say it was closed from the other side, it said it was just locked, so clearly I have to go get a key from someone. Some shortcuts that get opened up, because I kill a lot of dudes to get here, and then there's a boss right up here. Just don't see any though. I mean, this game is really hard, so I guess it does really surprise me if they kind of just make me fight for all those guys and that kind of boss. But back and look. useful if there was a shortcut that would get me here. Remember how there was that ladder before? I don't know if this is the same tower I was in before. Or if somehow I could get over there. See how there's like a little spot back there on the other side of that building? Maybe there's a way to get over there somehow. Maybe I like walk along this wall or something. Which you can do if you... Let's see here. I don't know if I can walk along this wall. It's not gonna work. No. That's not gonna work. No way. Absolutely not. I just... It's weird. Oh yeah, I did try to fight this guy before and I died horribly. He's big. Maybe if I like, kind of string him along. If that had a high rating, I might try it, but... should I even try for this guy? I mean, that could be a shortcut back. And then all I would have to do is come up here, fight those three guys, and then head to the final boss. I kind of want to try him, actually. That before I do that, if I get some of this, let's get this humanity here too. He's really slow. Invade another. Oh, yeah. If I throw these black fire bombs at him, maybe I can kill him like that. And just to be safe, I'd probably better add those other fire bombs. Alright. He's really slow, so I'm kind of... That could have gone better. Oh. try this again. Ah! So it's like, there clearly is a way to get back here, but. Backside of this building is that area. I have to drop down from up there somehow. I think that might be the key. Up there, and I can drop down over there. Let's see if I can figure this out. That big guy was too tough. Get over here. Look at that. Masterful. It's like, okay. Guess the only way down is this way. There's that. That bridge coming. That's where the stairway went down. Anyway, I don't think that's helping me. They didn't make me fight that big guy in that like narrow little hallway. Guy. like fighting this guy on the stairs because he can't stab up at me. In some respect, I should probably take those back and turn them in, because I could probably get two or three levels out of those. It's not going to be enough to get that big guy, though. Oh, man. I remember in the Bloodborne, there was a big guy in a hall, too. Seem like there's much over there. Maybe if I go turn my souls in, I'll do that. I'm gonna whip out, go back, turn my stuff in. I've accumulated too much. I wish I could level up without actually getting to being at the bonfire. That thing's pretty solidly in place. Alright, let's see here. Strength. Kind of kind of wild. Sure. I see people. I don't know. That was a waste. These firebomb guys. Didn't.
try falling down on this, but to be honest, that's probably not going to go very well.
The towers that I started at are all over there, and so any shortcut... This actually looks like a shortcut. Which is why I play around fighting this guy again. But he was a bad... He was a bad guy to fight with. He messed me up real fast. So I'm thinking I'll probably die again if I go up. So I'm just gonna head up here and instead I'll die in the boss. Man, I just wish like... Let's see, like, locked. Broken. Weakness. Jumping off. I don't know what that means. Rating 1. I did it. I did notice this first thing. These guys got it all boarded up in here. Was health doing that? I think I did. That was not smart. Alright, I guess I'm gonna go get killed by this guy. Pretty late. I think I'm gonna go to bed. So, thank you for joining me on my first ever stream. If you guys are watching this later, it doesn't look... There might have been a couple people bumping in and out of here, but... So I don't think
I'll probably get back to it maybe tomorrow night. And then I'm going to be gone for a little while, so...
Trying to do another one soon. Alright, thanks everyone for tuning in. See you later.